Steeped in tradition, the kimono has long been at the heart of Japanese culture. Originally worn by commoners or as an undergarment by the aristocracy, it became the most popular item of clothing for men and women of all classes by the 16th century.
Kimono is a really iconic garment, but I think people think of it as timeless and traditional costume. So our exhibition is really trying to promote the kimono as a fashionable garment to show that since the mid-17th century, it's always been a highly fashionable, dynamic way of dressing. Why we are doing it now is because there's quite a kimono renaissance going on in Japan.
Today's fascination echoes its past popularity, with an increasingly wealthy merchant class demanding the latest styles, and with famous courtesans setting the trends, kimono culture caught on beyond Japan.
Many kimonos were made specifically for the export industry, which influenced fashion around the world from the 18th century right through to the present day.
It's easy to get lost in its beauty, but the kimono acts as a map. From the colour and design to the length of the sleeves, every detail indicates the social status of the wearer.
So obviously, the girl who wears this costume comes from an affluent family. And this particular kimono, you see iris. Iris is a seasonal flower, the blooming only in May, so we because a sense of season is very important for us. So we don't wear this kimono and other than in May.
Now a new generation of designers want to unlock the hidden mysteries of this seemingly simple, straight-seamed garment.
This exhibition really explores the wide-ranging influence that the kimono has had, not only in Japan, but also globally. From those worn centuries ago, to those seen on the silver screen, like this one created specifically for Obi-Wan Kenobi in Star Wars. Kasia Madeira, BBC News, London.